man, you shouldn't be paying no girls' bills if y'all not married. I don't believe in that.
The opposite is the same.
Because I know, I already feel it. Yeah. I feel it growing in the comments. And I'm going to tell y'all right now, as a man, you should not be paying no girls' bills if that is not. Let me also say.
Yo, what's good, everybody? This is the Energy Coach back with another energy report. And today we talking about toxic behaviors in relationships for men and women. And we got some other things going. I want to start off with this because, man, that is something that is just, it should be a no-no. Because on one side, it's like the guy be thinking that he could buy his way in. Then on the other side, if she not really, really into you, she could decide to cut it off at any time. And you're not getting that money back. I think you got to be careful with who you be trying to cash out on. But we live in such a trick and hoe society, you feel me, that has become common. But yeah, I thought that was interesting. To start off with. Now, I got some other videos I want to kick it off with and get the ball rolling. You know what? I'm going to get the ball rolling with this one.
Women post these pictures like she's a bad bee, but she has a good heart. Women do not post things about their character. They're just trying to look as sexy as possible, and they don't understand you're getting sexual attention, but you're not getting relationship intention. Mm-hmm. These men they don't care about you because your character doesn't speak. They only see your body parts. Why does a man even have to tell you to change your Instagram? Mm-hmm. Your Instagram, you should be presenting as a wife. A lot of women will, God, where is my husband? Girl, he's out there, but you look like a hoe. You having to put your body and dress sexy, you are insecure.
Exactly.
Who you are as a woman, you've got to put it in the street because you have no intrinsic value. You don't know how to speak to men. You don't know what they value. Y'all don't know men. When they're looking for a wife versus a bust down, many women don't understand, well, I'm just cute. I'm at dinner. And your quote is about some bullshit. Like,
live
you
life,
can't
love.
See the air up here is clear because I'm done with the Dustin Brokey. Like,
so
ma'am,
done.
Like, your box is Dustin Brokey.
I thought that was interesting, but again, you're going to see a common theme today because we're talking about insecurities between men and women. It's true. A lot of women do be, I think they be competing with the things that they be seeing on social media, and a lot of them been kind of programmed to think that one thing promotes some type of personal strength or something, you know, like they put themselves out there and they'd be like, oh, well, you know, it makes me feel good. But I think it just really be for validation from social media and the attention. People get high off this social media, off these likes. So I thought that was interesting. Now, to piggyback on what she was saying about the dressing up, let's see how men feel about it, especially if they was in a relationship with someone like that on the opposite pole.
If I were to meet a woman who I liked very much.
Okay, this is not the one. But he's talking about something connected to that insecurity with that.
But she had X whatever, past whatever, whatever. My concerns would be, how do I know that I'm still the number one? How do I know I'm most important in her life? Especially if I don't measure up in certain key metrics. And two, the second thing that's most scary for men is, we understand that men are constantly after what we have. Like, your inboxes are all full. Like, they may not be with guys you want to reply to, but guys are still trying to get it. That's the male life. The male life is people are trying to take everything from me. And that's very scary. And you have to make your man really believe like that's impossible. If a man truly believes that nobody can take you from him, he's going to love you in a different way. You can give me two carbon copies of the same chick. But one, I think, might cheat in the right circumstances. And one, I know no matter what, would never leave me. The love I'll feel for this one is a different planet to the love I feel for this one. Even though they're the same person. If I were to meet a woman.
I think that's important because I don't think a lot of women be realizing how men operate and how they think. But I think it's also important that men need to operate how to know how they think and how they operate and be able to, you know, express that before they're jumping in relationships. Because a lot of time it just come off with flashing or other type. But let me go and piggyback off some more from this, and let's see what it was. Bing, bang.
What's wrong with a man being insecure about his woman having slept with a whole bunch of men?
Ooh, different types of insecurity. But again, it goes back to what the last video was talking about.
Now, that's what I really want to know the answer to, because I get tired of women saying, he's insecure, he's insecure. Okay, let's say you're right. So what? Now what? Yes, I'm insecure. I don't like the fact that you slept with a whole bunch of men. I don't like the fact that you were a sperm depository, a cum dumpster. I don't like that. So let's say that. Now that I've admitted that I'm insecure and that it bothers me because I'm worried about your fidelity, your loyalty to me. I'm worried about if you're going to fall back into your ways, your habits, that when you were sleeping around with these men, that is going to reveal itself in our relationship. I'm worried about if you're going to cheat. I'm worried about all of these things. I'd be concerned about the long-term benefits of dealing with promiscuous women. I'd be concerned about your oxytocin receptors densified to the point where you can't effectively pair bond, poor sexual discipline. You didn't receive orgasms from the guys that you dealt with, which means you constantly chase validation because you want an orgasm. So you constantly have sex with more guys trying to chase an orgasm. All of those things are correlated to women having higher body counts, not to mention the scientifically rooted perspective of we are repulsed by women with higher body counts because of a phenomenon known as paternity uncertainty, which means a promiscuous woman is more likely to cuck you, to have a baby by another man, and you don't know about it. What's wrong with a man being insecure?
That's very, very, very interesting. Very interesting. He had touched on something that I thought was, it was interesting. Now, I'm going to play this as far as from the opposite pole.
But if she's going out, it's a deal breaker for me.
Huge red flag.
That, for me, it's a deal breaker.
I totally agree.
Why is that a deal breaker? Is it because it makes you insecure?
It has nothing to do with insecurity. It's just, this is a dream world hypothetical scenario. Girls really don't be hitting up guys like this. Would you be okay with your long-term monogamous partner going to a nightclub, bar, or party type environment where throughout the course of the night, he's going to get approached, flirted with, and sexually pursued by numerous attractive women, some of which are more attractive than you and could potentially be a better partner than you, and these women are buying him drinks, getting him drunk, and enthusiastically want to sleep with him that night and steal him away from you? You're going to tell me you'd be okay with that?
No. Not with that. Definitely not.
So you can see how this can be a little contradictory, because none of you would be okay with it, right? But then you say guys should be okay with girls going out all the time.
If she's going out, it's a deal breaker for me.
There's a lot of different things that men, you feel me, have to be dealing with. But it's just putting it in these points of view that shed light on it differently. It was another one. Let me see. Something that was a little bit more interesting. Okay, boom.
Before I came to America, I didn't understand why so many...
Wait. Before we get to that one.
About to fire y'all up this Friday. You ever notice how women always have these long horror stories when it comes to any form of relationship, whether it be intimate or platonic? Oh, I never had a female friend over 2 years because they be hating. Oh, all my relationships was trash because they just didn't know how to handle a woman like me. But then you ask men, oh, you know, my last relationship trash, homegirl was crazy, whatever, it ain't work. But I had this ex back when I was 16, 17, and she was a great woman, but I messed up. I couldn't value that. And then they have friendships for over decades. Why do you think that is? Because as long as you cool, we cool. If you genuine, men are cool. It's no problem. Men don't look for situations off of conditions. It's women. Women either want to fuck with you for financial gain or for the aesthetic because you look good. You look good to hang around. Huh? Y'all always want to be a girl's girl until it's time to be one. Now you're trying to take away her shine to make you shine brighter. I thought you was bad, mama. What happened? Women be the problem. About to fire y'all up this Friday.
That was pretty interesting. She was also cooking. She was on point with a couple of things. She was on point. Hang on. Now, this was the... I'm talking about more toxic things.
A very toxic and very hidden trait in the female narcissist that isn't noticed as often or talked about very much is what I defined as feigned innocence. And this is a big one, and they all do it. This subtle but impactful behavior involves the art of acting naive or unaware, particularly when faced with their own misdeeds. So, for example, they adopt an air of innocence as if they were oblivious to the consequences of their behavior. And this isn't accidental. It's a calculated move to manipulate the situation. A very toxic and very hidden trait in the female...
I think that is something. Yeah, that's something intense, man. It's something that it definitely do be happening. Matter of fact, to piggyback off of that, let's see.
Cause I'm gonna tell y'all some GS shit. It don't matter how much you want to cap flaws and fake. A lot of these hoes, bro, and I know this because I'm a female. I know how females talk. I know what a bitch be sitting around saying with their homegirls, young or old. A lot of these females, man, their mindset is to get with y'all and make you take care of them. Get all that they can get out of you. And the minute they ain't getting what society or what their homegirls or what their mammy told them they should be getting out of you, they'll fuck over you, use you, take you for all you got, or at least try to, or use a baby as a pawn to control the way the fuck you move because they couldn't control you. Y'all gotta understand, when you run across females with a different mindset, where they genuinely care about your well-being, where they give a fuck about submission and allowing their man to lead, where they give a fuck about actually, you know, doing and buying for you and spoiling you the same way they want to be spoiled, that's a real bitch, boy. You better keep on your team. Who you faking trying to act like all these hoes got this type of mindset? Because I'm telling you,
yes, she not lying. She not lying. You will go through a lot trying to find one that be on point, and you won't. It's not that. It is definitely not that. It was something that piggybacked off of that. Aha. Oh, okay. Now, boom. Bingo.
So, he came home, and he was like, you know, babe, I lost my job. I'm like, all right, cool. So, a month later, like, the bills, it was time for the bills or whatever. You know, and I'm like, you know, the bills due, babe, or whatever. And he was like, okay, you know, I'm not working. And I'm just, in a month, like, it's all kind of hustles. You could have been doing something or whatever. So, I told him, I said, look, if I pay these bills, are you going to pay me the money back? This man had the nerve to tell me, why should I pay my wife back for paying our bills? I told this man from day one, my money is my money, and his money is our money. Why should I spend my money paying the bills? Like, no, he should have paid me back. So that's when I decided, like, I can't be with this man no more. So I had sex with his homeboy. Like, we all cool. I texted his homeboy or whatever. You know, we went together, I met up with him, and we was chilling, we was drinking or whatever, and I started venting, you know, like, I started getting emotional. One thing led to the next. I did not purposely mean to do what I did with his friend, but things happen, like, y'all understand what I'm going through. So, you know, his friend ended up giving me some money or whatever, and he was like, you know, babe, look, don't worry about it, handle whatever you gotta handle. Like, his friend was every single thing I desire in a man. Like, everything I desire in a man. And, you know, ain't nobody trying to hear my side.
I don't know if this was a skit or not. Man, I hope it was a skit, because that was cutthroat. I was like, ooh, that was cold-blooded. Yeah, that was tough. But two of those things to go off of this.
My mom put me on this type of game. She said, in this new wave of love, the new love is, I'm finding any reason to leave. The old love is, I'm finding any reason to stay.
Big difference. Now,
women want to know what a man is doing with his dick when she's not, because she's worried about, this is her own.
Now, this made me think about the female that was before Cam Newton just now, this video, and I was just like, let's see what he's talking about.
Concern. For the most part, this is her only value.
Man,
she can't cook, she can't sew, she can't balance her budget, she can't control the deficit of the household to make sure the credit grew. So her only value is calming and making you calm. So she have to wonder where your dick is going. Because that other woman might could cook over there. That other woman might get your credit clean with that good dick. So that's her only value. So most women worry about a nigga with what he's doing with his dick, but they're not worried about being better women. They're going through his phone, but they're not researching no goals.
Right.
They don't have any aspiration other than where you being, what you doing.
Right.
Oh, Lord.
Well, why ain't no pictures hung up on the wall? Why you ain't done nothing in this house? Why you ain't advanced our lives? Why you so worried? So that's the biggest problem that people have in relationship, worrying about dick and pussy.
We never create no business concepts. We be in relationship 5-6 years and never write down one business plan, but we going through each other's social media platform. And that take that takes a lot to do. Right. Women want.
I think that was, that last thing was on point. Like, people be getting so hooked up on the sex, you feel me, that they don't really be building nothing together. And it's like, they be so focused on just that. Now, it was something else, you feel me, that was on point. Now, as a positive, you feel me? Cause it ain't all bad. And again, this, I don't even think this is the majority, but I do see a lot of this happening more and more on social media with these kind of things. And I think the mentality is just a little off. And I think a lot of it be the way dudes be approaching and what they be looking for, and what they be Xing off. So based off of that, I want to play this.
I was like 16, 17. We was at the club. My uncle told me, stop looking at that that you want and start looking at that little funny looking in the corner just looking at you, because that woman finna do everything for you. That woman gonna turn mountains into molehills. The woman that you want gonna turn molehills into mountains. The value that a woman brings to the table makes her bad to me. So the looks ain't even gonna be the first thing. Y'all put that before everything. I'm putting what a woman's doing for me before everything. You could call me what you want, but you see, with me, she doing something for me. She ain't giving me no problems. This woman treat me like a guy. Yeah. So she bad to me. I don't give a fuck what she look like. I could get her lips done, her face done, her titties done, her teeth done. I could get all that done. Everybody want a bad bitch. Why? I want to treat me right, because your life would be hell with a do look good but give you problems every 2 seconds. I can't live like that. What do looks do for me? It gives me some status when I go out and other dudes see me with you. And if I don't give a f- about the opinions of others, then really I just got dead weight sitting here. However you treat me is your status to me. She a 10 because she treat me right. And that's what more dudes should be having that in their mind, is that I just want the baddest. Well, to redefine what bad is to you.
I think that was on point, man. You gotta, we gotta start going after more, you know, than just the looks. Especially because, now I'm not saying, you feel me, that it gotta be all fake and you feel me, rebuilt, because there's a lot of natural beauty out here, like, you know. But I think niggas be so hypnotized by what they done seen in entertainment that they don't be knowing what to look for. You feel me? It be a lot of ones that be on point that get slept on because you looking too much for, you know, the what look like entertainment, what look like the magazines, what look like, you feel me, the what you see in these music videos. Now I want to play this because I thought this was real interesting. I see this happening.
People in Japan.
I see this happening coming here soon because relationships are doing bad. So
let's see. And are now marrying their friends over romantic partners. Young Japanese people are now engaging in legal unions called friendship marriages. These marriages center around companionship rather than romance or sex. They provide practical benefits such as tax breaks, societal acceptance, and the ability to live together or apart and pursue outside relationships. Couples will openly discuss living arrangements, finances, and even fridge space before tying the knot to ensure compatibility. Japan's first friendship marriage agency, called Colorus, has facilitated around 500 marriages since 2015. With some even raising children. The agency reports around 1.24 million people are possible candidates for such an arrangement. The average participant is 32.5 years old, well-educated, and financially stable. Around 70% of friendship marriages aim to have children. People in Japan are now married.
I thought that was kind of crazy because I could see it happening here. Like, I can see that happening here because there's something going on with the relationships. But the issue is a lot of people don't take the time to actually get to know each other and become friends, like build that rapport first. Like, you know, like, yeah, y'all can do what y'all be doing, but man, y'all gotta really spend hours on the phone just talking. Spend hours, you know, like just around each other before y'all just start engaging. You know, get a good feel for each other. Hours, days, weeks, you know, before y'all just decide to get serious. Because, yeah, things can change after the honeymoon phase, you know. But tell me what y'all think. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I will catch y'all on the next one.